would be a killer application for Brownie. Let's hack TriCrypto. What we're looking at is the new Curve TriCrypto pools. They combine volatilely priced assets, so a dollar is coexisting in a pool of Bitcoin and Ethereum. And most impressively, all these assets are sitting in the same pool. You can freely move between them. And it's able to compute the price internally. It's not relying on any external oracle. Just by the activity on the pool, it's able to adjust. There's also about 300 million in it. So since this is a fairly new concept, if there's a mistake, maybe we can get that 300 million for ourselves. It's worth a shot, right? So one way to attack this would be to read through the white paper. Your kids will probably be studying this in school, so it's worth getting a sense of how it works. Problem is, if you don't know hypersurfaces, mathematical invariants, it can be a little bit tough. So if you don't want to try and understand how it works by solving these complex algorithms, you can take not the theoretical, but the experimental approach. Experimental physics does not care how to calculate the oracle price. We're just going to poke and prod the pool, see if we can understand its behavior, and maybe even exploit it. So we'll go ahead and launch a Brownie console. Brownie console is always great when you're trying to play around. And we'll load up the TriCrypto pool, which I've assigned to an alias. With other Curve pools, there's a concept of a virtual price. As the assets get traded, the LP token becomes more valuable, trading fees get assigned to it. And generally, these are fixed price assets. So the virtual price just directly reflects, you know, if this is a dollar pool, that would be worth $1.002. The TriCrypto pool is dealing with volatilely priced assets. So the price basis is a weighting of the three assets. In other words, if you look at the balances of zero, Tether, and the balances of one, and the balances of two, Bitcoin, Ethereum, the price is somewhere in between the three of these. One way to pull this out, since these are all three different scales, you can loop through all three of these. We're going to pull the price based on its internal oracle. This exists for two of the assets and has 10 to the 18th decimals. And that, as mentioned, that's for if I is greater than zero, Ethereum and Bitcoin. If it's Tether, then the price is simply one. Decimals, we're going to pull. We'll also pull the symbol. And we'll just print on one line the results of our math, which is take the balances of the coin, multiply by the price, and divide by 10 to the decimals. And look at that. Those three assets, when you convert to by price and decimals, are almost perfectly in balance. So you kind of start to get a sense of how it's calculating. Basically looking at trying to balance these assets. So we mentioned that it's calculating this price based on the activity. So why don't we just put the pool through some extreme activity, which we can test because we're on a mainnet fork. And if you check the GitHub repository, all the scripts are there. And we've created one called TriPool Nuke. And what we're going to do is we're going to look at the current state of the pool based on what we just showed. Then we're going to nuke the pool. What do we mean by nuke the pool? We're going to take $1 million 200 times in a row and deposit in the pool. See how this imbalances and adjusts the price based on these assets. And then when we're done, we're going to reverse the process. We're going to nuke it 100 times, 200 times the other direction. So I've gone ahead and ran this script ahead of time so we can see the results. We start in this nice balance state and it has the price in the scale. The thing to note with the price and the scale is that the scale is trying to push towards the price, but it does so as an exponentially weighted moving average. So it takes several different steps and it always moves towards the direction of the price. We see this reflected when we look after we drop the nuke. So we start with almost 100 mil of each asset. After the nuke, we've got $300 million worth of USDT. And we note this has moved the price up. So the price of Bitcoin has gone from 46K to 53K almost. scale pushing in that direction a little bit less. And the price of Ethereum has pushed up to 37K. Again, the scale pushing in that direction, so it's lags ever so slightly. Now, you'll notice something about this. The pools added a bunch of Bitcoin and Ethereum, but no deposits were made other than us nuking the pool with dollars. You can also see this effect as we reverse the nuke. So as we pull the 200 million out of the pool, we now see the pool weighted in the other direction. The Bitcoin and Ethereum have actually crept upwards, and the US Tether token has crept way below it. So even though we've pulled out $200 million, we have $200 million in Tether in the bank, minus just a little bit. The final state of the pool is that Bitcoin and Ethereum is even higher balanced. And you can see the adjusting price action accordingly. Pretty interesting. Could we exploit this? Is there a potential arbitrage opportunity? Clearly, with enough money and enough transactions, we can adjust the price of the pool. Could we massively drive the price of these assets up and then trade them on another exchange? So we've included an ARB script. And the ARB script does just this. First, it nukes the pool. Then it tries to see if there's an arbitrage opportunity. And if there is, then it acts on it. The arbitrage opportunity can take two different forms. We can go one direction, which means we can try and ape into sushi and then take the balance out of TriCrypto, or we can go TriCrypto sushi. Again, I've gone ahead and ran this, and we can see the results over here. So again, this time we're only dealing with 100 nukes, which is enough to move the price. And when we go first through TriCrypto, then back through sushi, not a good strategy, we lose 500K. But the second strategy looks like we're onto something. We've yielded almost $1 million in profit. Not bad for a day's work. I mean, you need 200 million to get there. So what happens when we go and actually run this? In this case, we're just testing the ARB. What happens when we actually run the arbitrage, reverse the nuke, try and get our money out? Well, something interesting happens. Again, we nuke, we grab the money, and as we unnuke, we find our final balance is, we lost $250,000. What's going on? I'll leave this as an exercise for the commenters. What do you think happened? How did we fail to make money off this obvious arbitrage opportunity? As you consider, remember this here. As the pool adjusted in value, it internally transferred a few assets, taking profit where it could and adjusting that way. Food for thought, consult the white paper. But lest you think that it is still possible to hack the pool, we've gone ahead and included a integrative script. So this is in the tests integrative folder. We have basically taken the same strategy we ran there, the nukes, but we've allowed you to vary these parameters. So you can run this between $1,000 and $50 million. You can try any number of trials from 250 to 1,000. And maybe the number of unnukes and nukes needs to be slightly imbalanced. Good luck. All you need to do is sit over here, run this script, and if it happens to find a strategy that fails, that is, the final amount is greater than the amount we put in the ARB, this script will stop running. Don't hold your breath.